What should be the United States' next move on hypersonic technology? The future of hypersonic weapons. One of the most hyped, debated and costly weapons initiatives in years. But while they chewed over the obstacles of supply chains, acquisition and testing facilities, hovering in the background were high-profile Chinese advancements in the cutting-edge weapons, Russian President Vladimir Putin's boasts of his nation's progress on hypersonic technology, and questions at whether the United States is on the right track. The Defense Department is at a critical moment on hypersonic technology. Now, a growing chorus of experts, including a service secretary, are urging the government to add resources for building an array of sensors, satellites and other technologies to improve America's ability to defend against hypersonic attacks. In other words, is the United States approaching hypersonic technology from the right angle? In recent months, Air Force Secretary Frank Kendall has repeatedly asked pointed questions about the purpose they should play in the U.S. arsenal and whether they're worth the considerable price tag. Can you do the job with conventional missiles at less cost? The hypersonic market was one of the drivers of Lockheed Martin's attempted $4.4 billion acquisition of Aerojet Rocketdyne, a maker of vital parts for scramjet engines that go into hypersonic missiles. Lockheed hoped acquiring Aerojet and its propulsion capabilities would allow it to integrate the technology into its broader engineering department and operate faster and more cheaply. In the U.S., the Army, Navy, Air Force, and Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency all are working on hypersonic programs, some in cooperation with one another. These include the All Up Round, a joint Army and Navy program, the Air Force's AGM-183 Air Launched Rapid Response Weapon, or ARRW, and DARPA's Hypersonic Air Breathing Weapon Concept, which is under development in partnership with the Air Force. At a February conference, Lockheed CEO Jim Taiclet noted the company's work on six hypersonic programs, and called hypersonics a national priority. Northrop Grumman last year began construction on a 60,000-foot facility in Maryland to better design and produce hypersonic weapons systems. Hypersonic weapons can travel multiple times faster than the speed of sound, greater than Mach 5, and can maneuver mid-flight. This makes them capable of penetrating defenses and much harder to track and shoot down than conventional ballistic missiles, which follow a predictable parabolic track. Both China and Russia have invested heavily into hypersonic technology. What China and Russia might do with hypersonic technology isn't necessarily what the United States would want to do. As a result, the US doesn't need to match China and Russia in every move in the hypersonic realm, particularly given the weapon's high price tag. Kendall recommends the US examine potential targets and find the most cost-effective way to hit them, and in some cases, that might not involve a hypersonic weapon. The military also needs to consider cost, he added. The Government Accountability Office said in a report last year the government is likely to spend nearly $15 billion between 2015 to 2024 to develop hypersonic weapons across 70 different efforts. Kendall is asking the right questions, said John Venable, a senior defense fellow at the Heritage Foundation. The weapons could cost anywhere from $50 million to $100 million apiece, he explained, though the hope is to get them down to $50 million a shot, and the military needs to consider what targets would justify using such an expensive munitions. But the US should do more to build its defenses. The US to do more to strengthen its defensive abilities to detect, track and intercept hypersonic weapons. The report, Complex Air Defense: Countering the Hypersonic Missile Threat, argued fielding a defense will involve a multi-layered approach, including new sensing and interceptor capabilities. Most importantly, the nation will need a layer of space sensors that can spot, classify and track missiles of any kind and along any path. On this front, the Space Force, Space Development Agency and Missile Defense Agency are working together to build a new missile warning and tracking architecture. This could include a mix of wide field of view and medium field of view satellites in low Earth orbit under development by MDA and the Space Force's work to modernize its missile warning and tracking satellites. The US also needs a glide phase interceptor. So far, the government has only invested modestly in developing hypersonic defenses, compared to the funding for a hypersonic strike capability. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.